morning sun shines on the gleaming hide of a muscular ranch horse. The aroma of bacon and coffee drifts from the wood cook stove at a cow camp. Silver spurs jingle as the men and women of the West get set for another day in the saddle. From the heart of Canada's finest ranching country, this is the Spirit of the West with rancher and horse trainer Hugh McLennan and his collection of music, poetry, and conversations with the folks who live and work with horses and cattle in the Spirit of the West.
You know, I don't think a day goes by, rain or shine, stormy or clear, or like it is now, snowbanks 10 feet high, that Billy and I don't look around and reflect on how thankful we are to still be out here in this beautiful part of the West, still be able to saddle up at the barn and ride out for hours, and not see any signs of civilization. And this week, you'll hear Terry Nash reflect on that.
I long for the small things that come with the life, like saddling a mount at morning's first light.
Terry will be in the Cowboy Poetry Spotlight, and you'll be able to see him and meet him at the Kamloops Cowboy Festival in a couple of weeks. And I'll look into a number of issues on the Rangeland News, and one thing we'll look at is farm and ranch income.
Livestock, hogs and cattle both up from last year, same for milk.
Baxter Black took a trip through a big museum the other day, and every prehistoric exhibit he looked at reminded him of someone.
Figuring out how to shave 2 cents off of the price, all he needed was a cheap cigar to look like your typical everyday packing house buyer.
On the Urban Saddles and Western Wear horse training file, I'll have a couple of observations on the TV series The Wild Ones, now running on the Discovery Channel. And Don Howard is back on the line this week with more of the real-life situations he's been through.
It was a pretty good-sized calf, too. This was in August. Anyway, I ran down to release it, and that cow was just on me like a mama bear, I'll tell you.
And I know that our friend Jim Reeder starts calving early in the season, so let's check in with him right now. How's it going out there, Jim?
I'm 3 weeks into calving time, and I'm 2 weeks behind on a matrimonial payment plan evidently I had signed. My wife said next year she's gonna take care of being crews. She claims she never sees when all my calves are due. And I said, whoa, whoa, honey, cut me a little slack. Well, I'm a ranching man, and this you knew, and you smiled and said, I do. And she said, whoa, whoa, honey, let's get something straight. If I was a four-legged critter, I'd be someone with whom you would relate. Best if I just stayed and hung around. My dinner, it was hot at 6 by 11, freezing cold. Oh, but nothing quite compared to the iceberg at the door. She said, whoa, whoa, honey, cut me a little slack. The best one of the bunch after you. And I said, whoa, whoa, honey, cut me a little slack. Well, I'm a ranching man, and this you knew when you smiled and said, I do. And she said, whoa, now hold on, honey, let's get something straight. If I was a four-legged critter, I'd be someone with whom you would relate. Yeah, if I was a four-legged critter, someone with whom you would relate.
You know, one thing that always helped us get through calving season was looking ahead to the spring brandings. And as you may know, I do love being on a good horse with my rope in hand in the branding trap. And my friend from the Cruisin' Cowboy Band, Don Howard, just called in, and while Jim Reeder was singing, we were talking about that.
Sometimes it just works that way, doesn't it?
Yeah, and other times you'll just go out there and everything shapes up, and it just seems like you hardly ever miss, you know.
Isn't that true?
And you're down to the last calf. And, yeah, they're usually and oh gosh, and
their way through the bunch.
Yeah, and you'll try, and he's been slapped on the hocks 5 or 6 times, so he knows how to kick it off right away.
Well, do you leave the cows in with the calves out there?
Sometimes, yeah. If there's a few headhunter cows, we'll sort them out.
Yeah.
But I prefer to have quite a few cows in with the calves.
I always did too. And that sort of settled the calves down. Otherwise, the calves start running.
Oh, I know. They get pretty panicky.
Yeah.
And I find quite often if the calf is kind of behind the cow, I can sneak up on him a little easier before he even sees me coming.
Yeah.
And if I shape it up right before I know it, before he knows it, you know, those two heels, one step ahead, and we got him. Like that.
That's right.
I understand that you, I drink my coffee black. I have since I was a kid. No cream, no sugar, but you prefer, I understand, cream or milk in your coffee.
I do. I cannot stand my black coffee, so I suppose you're thinking of that one little story in there.
Yeah.
Well, my dad died some years back now, and we were cleaning up the old house down here in the coulee. He had just been staying in there to calve some cows. Clothes in there, and Carmen and I were doing pretty good at straightening it up. It's always a tough job cleaning up a loved one's belongings after. But anyway, we decided to have a cup of coffee, and we got to open the fridge, and there's an old stale donut in there. So I said, gosh, I can't drink that coffee black. I'm going to go out. I'll be back. So I grabbed a clean cup, and we had a range cow out in the corral. I hadn't gotten out to summer pasture yet, so I threw a loop on her and snubbed her to the fence, and after a few wild kicks, I had a nice cup of fresh milk or cream.
Well, you wrote about a friend of yours who had an even more surprising way to find some cream or milk for his coffee. Let's get to that one when the Spirit of the West continues right after this. How about a weekend pass to the 24th annual Kamloops Cowboy Festival, March 19th to 22nd, 2020? Another outstanding lineup of the finest pure Western entertainers anywhere. Canadian legend Gary Velgar.
Searching for freedom, westward the wagons, they settled in the valleys of sagebrush and pine.
Tom Cole.
In a big prairie moon. Rides a big prairie sky.
The first Kamloops appearance for Doug Figgs.
A good horse under me, it's easy to see. I'm right here where I want to be.
A pasture full of great cowboy poets, the BC Cowboy Hall of Fame inductions, dinner shows, daytime entertainment, and a spectacular art and gear show workshop. The best place to get all the information, bcchs.com. To order tickets, call 1-888-763-2221. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West. Don Howard has been in the saddle working cattle in southern Alberta, short grass country in the Hand Hills area all his life. It's not the picturesque hills of Wyoming, the rolling foothills of the eastern slopes, or the broad grasslands of the Nicola Valley. It's dry, short grass punctuated with coulees and draws. But it's cowboy country for sure. And Don's second book, Wild Garlic and Don Sense, is full of stories from his life with his wife Carmen and the folks they rode with. And Don's on the line from the home ranch again today, and we were talking about calving, and sometimes even cowboys have to milk cows.
I remember, you know, milking out a lot of cows with bad bags or whatever, or calves that are too weak to suck, and getting the colostrum out of them, and getting it into them as quick as we could. But we made one mistake, Don, a few years ago. Like Billy and I always kind of tried to keep at least a nice cream pail of colostrum in the deep freeze we'd taken out of, you know, we had a couple of cows that milked really well. And after they calved, we could, you know, milk a good ice cream pail out of them almost and keep it in the freezer. And then we'd thaw it out slowly if we had a calf that couldn't nurse. But I also really like butterscotch ripple ice cream.
Yeah.
And I don't know what happened. We got some water in the back of the truck on the way home, and all the labels came off the pails and stuff. And we just found out much later that the calves didn't do well on that melted butterscotch ripple ice cream. And that frozen colostrum isn't good on apple pie.
That's a good one.
But
see where it would mixed up.
That really happened. I don't know. You don't always have a cow that's got milk handy if you need cream in your coffee. You know. Wasn't there a guy in your roping club or somewhere that found another way to get milk in his coffee?
Oh, yeah. He was quite a character. That's Lynn Murray. Yeah, he's since they died in a crash in D.C., which was unfortunate, him and his son and their wives. But anyway, yeah, we ran out of coffee at a trail ride, and he said, just a minute, I'll go out and get some. And
there would be no cows anywhere then.
No cows anywhere. And he went back in with a half a cup of different-looking milk. He'd gone out and milked his mare, Cindy, and she was a good milker, and he brought in his horse, the cream.
Wow, she must have had a foal on her then.
Yeah, she had a foal on
her.
Yeah,
oh, for gosh sake. Never.
She just did everything for him.
Oh, man.
She barrel raced, she roped calves, she fed us cream for her coffee even.
Oh, man. Well, there is another episode that I want to get to, Don, about the time you couldn't resist dropping your loop on a big calf and how things went sideways from there. First, though, speaking of coffee, here's Montana's High Country Cowboys.
Well, we got the herd bedded for the night. My work's done for the day. I ride up to where we are camped, about a quarter mile away. Oh, a pot of coffee is brewing, beans and bacon smell real fine. As I climb down from my cow pony to rest them bones of mine. Well, the trail boss comes up to me, says, what are you doing here? Don't you know it's your turn to stand guard, so get out there with them steers. You can wait and have your victuals when your night watch is all through. So forget about your coffee, cause a storm's starting to brew. Old cold coffee, I know that's what I'll get. Some old burnt beans, some bacon fat, and old dried out biscuit. Old cold coffee, this is my day to lose. I'm just a lonesome cowboy, got the old cold coffee blues. Well, I get back where the cattle are and the thunder rolls around. I left my slicker back at camp as the rain starts pouring down. Well, I get chilled deep down in my bones and the wind blows in my face. As I wait for 3 long hours more for someone to take my place. Well, the moon finally comes back inside, my relief rides down the hill. And as I ride back up to camp, hope there's some grub left still. Well, the fire's nearly burned itself out and the coffee's getting cold. The beans were left out in the rain and the biscuits growing mold. Old cold coffee, I know that's what I'll get. Some old burnt beans, some bacon fat, and an old dried out biscuit. Old cold coffee, this is my day to lose. I'm just a lonesome cowboy, got the old cold coffee blues. Well, the cookie comes along and says, why on earth were you so late? Now hurry up and eat your grub and don't forget to wash your plate. Well, I guess this just wasn't my day, and there's one thing that's true. When things go wrong, they sure go wrong, got the old cold coffee blues. Old cold coffee, I know that's what I'll get. Some old burnt beans, some bacon fat, and an old dried out biscuit. Old cold coffee, this is my day to lose. I'm just a lonesome cowboy, got the old cold coffee blues. Odelay, odelay, yay, odelay.
Cold coffee. Coffee Blues, three brothers from Montana there, the High Country Cowboys, talented guys. John is an award-winning Western artist, Marty's a great saddle maker and leather worker, and Joe builds beautiful guitars that the band plays. Now, it's back to Don Howard on the line from the home ranch, and Don, there's another story in your new book about the time when you, like a lot of us, just couldn't resist dropping your loop on a big calf as you went riding along.
That had to be down on the river flats. Yeah, I just couldn't resist it there. I was mounted on a pretty good rope horse, and this calf and cow were going ahead of me there, and I took out a loop, and I just had to throw that loop on that calf. It was a pretty good-sized calf, too. This was in August. Anyway, I ran down to release it, and that cow was just on me like a mama bear, I'll tell you. And Murray Johnson was riding alongside of me, and he pushed the cow off, thank goodness. Gave me time to release the calf. Yeah.
But you were helping another neighbor, or your blood testing, right? And you did a lot of years of doing that. And you've had a lot of adventures with some of the, you know, the chutes that you had to work with and that kind of things. And there was a kind of an edgy cow that you're having a hard time getting through the chute. And the ones behind were getting nervous. At the end of that, the boss had kind of an interesting comment. Just how did that one go again?
Yeah, he was using his own chute. And the last cows usually got a little edgy, you know, as they were, when the rest were all gone and through. Anyway, they missed catching her in the chute, and he hollered at his hired hand, "Stop that cow!" And this guy, the hand, he throws his hands up and he bellers a blood-curdling yell for the cow to stop, and boy, that just fueled her anxiety even a little bit more. And she took him and knocked him flying, and he was reaching for, it looked like he was reaching for some magic pole in the sky to grab a hold of. But anyway, she trampled over him, and off into the herd she goes. And he
just left hoof prints all over his body.
Oh, you bet. And he grabbed his crumpled up hat and walking back towards us there, and the boss says, as he's limping all along there, his boss says, "Did you get her tag number when she went over you?"
Right. Well, coming up, Baxter Black takes a trip through a big museum, and every prehistoric exhibit he looks at reminds him of a real person. Another good song, and then the Rangeland News when the Spirit of the West continues right after this.
Howdy, friends. This is Baxter Black on Spirit of the West with Hugh McLennan, and I'll be right back after this with a little peek at familiar faces in the museum.
Your land is a legacy, a challenge from those who tended it before you to build on their foundations. At Corteva Agriscience, we understand what it means to be the stewards of a legacy. We embrace the challenge of building on the foundation of Dow Agrosciences to maintain your trust, to bring new solutions, to help you care for your land. See how we can help build your legacy at rangeandpasture.com.
And for our Canadian listeners, just check corteva.ca, the Canadian website.
I took a trip to the Museum of Natural History, but as I walked through the halls and stared at the infinite variety of creatures who stalked the earth, I began to feel uneasy. I started seeing familiar faces looking back at me. There stood the reincarnated remains of Stegosaurus. He was 25 feet long, had a hump on his back, big spikes on his tail, and a skull about the size of a Spanish goat. The description said he wandered from place to place, grumbling about the mud and slashing his tail at his enemies. He had one brain the size of a walnut in his head that controlled his mouth, and another in his rear end that controlled his tail, and it is unlikely that the two brains communicated. Thus, one end never knew what the other was doing, so if his mouth wasn't getting him in trouble, the other end was. He looked like every feedlot cowboy I'd ever known. Back in the corner was Brother Walrus, weighing in at 700 pounds. I could picture him rounding the corner of the loading chute, sitting behind the wheel of his 98 town car, or hooking his tusks out of the window as he drove up and down the feedlot alley, figuring out how to shave 2 cents off of the price. All he needed was a cheap cigar to look like your typical everyday packing house buyer. And rearing up before me, 17 feet tall, with a head the size of a front-end loader, was Tyrannosaurus Rex. His big mouth and armory of teeth reminded me of Carlsbad Caverns. Every creature gave him a wide berth. His front paws were very small, good for very little except, possibly, counting money. He ate everything he could catch and showed no mercy, the fiercest carnivore that ever lived. Your friendly Aglone officer. And then I came upon a pitiful sight, a giant sloth mired in the tar pits. He was being attacked by two saber-toothed tigers, drug salesmen, six hyenas, government bureaucrats, an alligator, the implement dealer, and a covey of buzzards, assorted veterinarians, consultants, county agents, and commodity brokers. He was stuck in the tar, he couldn't get out, and even if by some miracle he did manage to extricate himself from the tar, he'd still have to fight his way through the hungry predators. Strangely enough, it occurred to me that if the giant sloth finally went under, so would the predators. And so it goes with the farmer and rancher. This is Baxter Black on Spirit of the West with Hugh McLennan, brought to you by Corteva Agriscience.
You're invited to the 39th Select Charley Bull Sale, March 6th at the Innisfail Auction Market. 115 Charley Bulls, two-year-olds and yearlings, horn-pulled, whites and tans, high-performance, top-quality Charley Bulls. The Marshalls and Shuttleworths look forward to seeing you Friday, March 6th at Innisfail. View the catalog online at www.futurefarms.ca. Or call Daryl or Alan and stop by and look at the bulls.
How about a weekend pass to the 24th annual Kamloops Cowboy Festival, March 19th to 22nd, 2020. Another outstanding lineup of the finest pure Western entertainers anywhere. Canadian legend Gary Veljar.
Searching for freedom, westward the wagons, they settled in the valleys of sagebrush and pine.
Tom Cole.
In a big prairie moon. Rides the big prairie sky.
The first Kamloops appearance for Doug Figgs.
A good horse under me, it's easy to see. I'm right here where I want to be.
A pasture full of great cowboy poets, the BC Cowboy Hall of Fame inductions, dinner shows, daytime entertainment, and a spectacular art and gear show workshop. The best place to get all the information, bcchs.com. To order tickets, call 1-888-763-2221.
The Rangeland News from the Spirit of the West. A roundup of issues and events from the world of agriculture.
Thank you, Jeff. And at the top of page one, it says, looking back at the year, Gary Crawford has some interesting numbers on what farm and ranch products produced more income and which ones produced less for ranchers and farmers.
If you look at December prices for farm commodities and factor in relative volumes of sales for the various farm products, as USDA statisticians have done, you get an average December price received index overall up 0.8% from November, down, though, that same percentage from December a year ago. Mostly, you have livestock prices up from a year ago, crops down. A few of the bulk crop commodities did buck that trend. Corn at an average $3.71 a bushel, up 3 from November and up 17 from a year ago. Wheat averaging $4.64 a bushel, up a quarter from November, down, though, 64 from a year ago. Soybeans a better story, climbing 11 cents in December to $8.70, 14 cents higher than December 2018. Livestock, hogs and cattle, both up from last year, same for milk. Broilers, though, selling for less. Now, for prices farmers paid to do business, those averaged 0.5% higher than 2018. Gary Crawford for the U.S. Department of Agriculture, Washington.
A study has found that rest stops during the transportation of cattle had little or to no effect on calves that were in good condition, according to some research. And Dr. Karen Schwarzkopf-Genswine from the Federal Research Station in Lethbridge said the difference between calves transported 36 hours or 12 hours with and without stops was only a bit of fatigue. She said this shows the impact on cattle is due to the transport itself. The study related to the Canadian Food Inspection Agency's new regulations that would allow no more than 12 hours on a truck for unweaned animals and a maximum of 36 hours for weaned animals with a required 8-hour rest. The regulations were to come into force later this month, but a 2-year grace period allows for more studies. And she said management of cattle before they are transported seems to have the greatest impact on how they withstand the ride in the liner. She said calves in good condition are able to cope with transport stress regardless of what period of rest they get.
Well, I'd just finished feeding the horses as the sun went down, and I got back in the house, sat down by the wood stove fire while Billy was putting the finishing touches on supper. And I picked up the February issue of Beef Illustrated. And at least three articles I found were really, I thought, worth mentioning. B.J. Smith's column on kids raised on a farmer-ranch environment really struck a chord. And one quick note from there, persistence is the strength of character that gives you the extra gear to solve problems. You can't pull half a calf. You must be up and nursing before you dry off and put your coat away. And I always love reading the feedlot adventures of Bruce Dirksen and faithful old Sonny. And there's a terrific story on the Slippery Moon Ranch by Lee Gunderson. And boy, that would make a great movie. Well, the Wandering Western Spirit Band will wander up to Fort St. John, B.C. for Concert 83 with my little brother Jim and his amazing guitar picking, along with our super bass player Uncle Mike, and we'll be joined by Tom Cole and friends at the Lido Theater in Fort St. John, two shows, May 22nd and May 23rd at 7 p.m. And tickets are available at thelido.ca, L-I-D-O.ca, or you can call 250-785-3011, or you can pick them up in person at the Lido on 100th Avenue. Sure, looking forward to reconnecting with all our good friends up there in the Peace Country. Well, March the 10th is the date of the next regular cattle sale at the BC Livestock Co-op in Kamloops. Regular sale in Williams Lake is March the 19th. And the regular sale in Vanderhoof is March the 20th. Get all the information and watch the sale streaming live at bclivestock.bc.ca. Meanwhile, out at the Innisfail Auction Market, there's another pre-sort feeder sale on March 2nd. Regular cattle sales every Wednesday and a lot of special sales coming up, including the 39th Annual Select Charley Bull Sale on March the 6th. You can see them all at InnisfailAuctionMarket.com or give Danny, Mark, or Dwayne a call, toll-free, 1-800-710-3166. And I know you've been waiting for another final item. And this one actually happened, too. The media has given a lot of coverage to the coronavirus situation. And since I had my kidney transplant, I show up at Life Labs once a month. That's Life Labs in Kamloops, once a month to have my blood tested before 8 o'clock in the morning. Last week, when I got there, all the lab technicians were wearing masks. Before they did my test, I was asked a bunch of questions. And I'm a little hard of hearing, and I couldn't read her lips with a mask on. But anyway, I got the drift of the questions. Did I have any flu-like symptoms? Had I been abroad lately or in contact with anyone who had been abroad? Well, I think I got the questions right, but after that I couldn't resist. I said, now, I should tell you, I did drink a Corona beer last week. And she didn't even smile. Anyway, that's the Rangeland News. Coming up on the Urban Saddles and Western Wear Horse Training File, I'll comment on the TV series The Wild Ones, now running on the History Channel. And there's more from Dawn Howard when the Spirit of the West continues right after this. How about a weekend pass to the 24th Annual Kamloops Cowboy Festival, March 19th to 22nd, 2020. Another outstanding lineup of the finest pure Western entertainers anywhere. Canadian legend Gary Velgar.
Searching for freedom, westward the wagons, they settled in the valleys of sagebrush and pine.
Tom Cole.
In a big prairie moon rides a big prairie sky.
The first Kamloops appearance for Doug Figgs.
A good horse under me, it's easy to see. I'm right here where I want to be.
Pasture full of great cowboy poets, the BC Cowboy Hall of Fame inductions, dinner shows, daytime entertainment, and a spectacular art and gear show workshop. The best place to get all the information, bcchs.com. To order tickets, call 1-888-763-2221. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West.
Ryan Fritz has just released a terrific new single, and he gets some help from some pretty prominent Western music stars, like Susie Boggess, Colter Wall, Corb Lund, and Ian Tyson, and you'll hear it coming up. You know, there's been some interesting comments on the horsemanship shown on the History Channel's series The Wild Ones, and I'll offer mine on the Urban Saddles and Western Wear Horse Training File coming right up. But first, Billy and I have spent some time reflecting on the wonderful times we've had after hosting over 1,200 people who love the Western way of life on 19 Spirit of the West cruises, after 120-some flights, over 90 hotel room visits, and through our challenges, including Billy's with radiation treatments and my journey with end-stage kidney disease, doing dialysis from Mexico to Alaska, that it's probably time for us to take a step back from cruise hosting after the next one. Ah, we have so many vivid memories and video of our members of our group ziplining in Mexico, having many memorable trail rides from Prince Edward Island to Mazatlan, walking down Broadway in New York City with the locals all wanting pictures of our cowboy hats, touring and visiting ranchers and farmers from Jamaica to Ireland, seeing the hidden treasures of Australia and New Zealand, the wonders of the Panama Canal, and so much more. And our unforgettable sing-along sessions with the Spirit of the West Choir. And we sure want to thank each and every one of you who joined us over the last 20 years. By booking with the Spirit of the West, you've helped us keep this program going all these years. Our farewell cruise called The Spirit of the West Brings It Home is coming up. We wanted to eliminate some of the hassles of long-distance travel and make it an unforgettable experience, so we'll gather you all up here at our ranch on July the 15th for a lunch and a concert with the Western Spirit Band and a special guest. From there, we go to the fabulous Sun Peaks Resort for a barbecue and sightseeing. The next morning, we all go down to the coast and we'll board the Holland America beautiful ship Koningsdam for a 7-day cruise up the Inside Passage and back. No flying required. This package includes the amazing White Pass Rail Tour and so much more. Now, this one is filling pretty fast, so if you'd like to join us, just call the number 1-800-530-0131 to reserve your spot. Deposits are refundable up until April the 3rd. And it seems like more great things are being added all the time as we get closer to this one. I just found out that after the coaches get us from Sun Peaks to Vancouver, we'll check into the beautiful Fairmont Waterfront Hotel right next to the cruise terminal, about the nicest place you could stay. And the next morning, before we board the Koningsdam, there is something really special planned just for the group, so stay tuned.
Now it's time for the Horse Training File, brought to you by Irvine Tack and Western Wear, Canada's largest Western store.
788, 789.
What you up to?
I'm counting all the saddles here at Irvine Tack and Western Wear. Rumor has it they have over 1,400.
Well, they are Canada's largest Western store with over 100,000 square feet of selection. Western Wear with a welcome twist and so many saddles, you'll likely lose count.
700 and... wait, where was I?
See what I mean?
Ugh. One saddle, two saddles.
Saddle up for Irvine's today. Exit 305 off Highway 2 by Crossfield.
Canada's largest Western store.
And, of course, you can shop online at urbansaddles.ca and see some of those 1,400-plus saddles there. Well, The Wild Ones, the reality TV series that's now running on the History Channel, is raising a few eyebrows, and I thought I should make a few observations. First of all, I really did enjoy the conversations with executive producer Barry Davis that you heard over the last couple of weeks, and I've got to say that I had only watched the first episode before we recorded the interview. I haven't seen any of the others. We set the PVR to record them, but I forgot that we were just getting a free preview of the History Channel, and it was over after episode one, so I still haven't seen the rest of them. But after watching the first one, I was thinking, that's not quite the way I'd go about capturing these horses. I worked and started quite a few colts that have been running wild in their first few years and found that in most cases, once you established a connection with them, their trust was unshakable and they'd do just about anything for you. I've also had the job of rounding up fairly big groups of horses that had been running free for several months, although they weren't what you'd call wild. But instead of trying to wear them down by chasing them, if possible, I'd set out some good quality hay in the big main enclosure and then just let them discover it. And once they got comfortable going in there and eating, I'd just hang out close by on one of my good horses and take a lot of time to let them get used to my presence there without harassing them in any way. And once they more or less accepted my horse and I as a part of the herd, then I'd work towards feeding them in the big enclosure, and once they were comfortable going in and out, I'd shut the gate on them, but make sure there was lots of feed and water available. Some of the principles I've learned to use when gathering cattle by myself would apply, but not all of them. Keeping them comfortable with me at the edge of their flight zone, trying to keep them as calm as possible, trying to avoid getting into a race with them, and working to build their curiosity and minimize their fear, to me would really be important. As I said, I haven't seen any more of the episodes, so I can't say too much, and I guess it makes for entertaining television. And just to refresh your memory, here's one of the things that Barry Davis did say last week.
Sure, some of your listeners will probably like cringe at a lot of the things that we do in the show, because it's not necessarily, it's made by people like myself who live in an urban environment and have a filmmaking and adventure background, but not necessarily a horse background.
And for Urban Saddles and Western Wear, that's the horse training file. Something that we find really important is the daily feeding of Hoffman's horse ration that our horses get. Find out what's in it at hoffmanshorseration.com. Come and see the largest selection of well-broke horses in Western Canada at the 7th Annual Top Gun Horse Sale. April 11th, high noon, at the CalNash Event Center, Ponoka, Alberta. You can preview the horses Friday, April 10th at 4 p.m. They start coming through the ring Saturday, April 11th at high noon. Over 200 horses expected. Horses for ranch work, team roping, penning, roping, trail riding, barrels, mounted shooting, and kids' horses. Every type of horse you might be looking for, including loads of true ranch horses. Every horse will be ridden, driven, or led into the ring. Rain or shine, everything's inside. For information and to see the horses, go to TopGunHorseSales.com or call Jordan Dodds, 403-783-0246. How about a weekend pass to the 24th Annual Kamloops Cowboy Festival, March 19th to 22nd, 2020. Another outstanding lineup of the finest pure Western entertainers anywhere. Canadian legend Gary Belger.
Searching for freedom, westward the wagons, they settled in the valleys of sagebrush and pine.
Tom Cole.
In a big prairie moon. Rides the big prairie sky.
The first Kamloops appearance for Doug Figgs.
A good horse under me, it's easy to see. I'm right here where I want to be.
A pasture full of great cowboy poets, the BC Cowboy Hall of Fame inductions, dinner shows, daytime entertainment, and a spectacular art and gear show workshop. The best place to get all the information, bcchs.com. Order tickets, call 1-888-763-2221. And in case you didn't know, Ian Tyson will be at the Kamloops Cowboy Festival, where we're going to present him with a special award. And of course, so will his neighbor Ryan Fritz, who wrote this terrific tribute. Listen for the names of so many of Ian's songs, along with the voices of Susie Boggess, Coulter Wall, Corb Lund, and Ian himself.
Screaming everybody up. The yellow dog still sleeping on the Navajo rug. Summer grass sweetens the morning air. And since the rain we have more than our share. Maybe there's a song there. gravel road with my pony's oats. Well, they know what I have for them, but I pretend that I don't. And we both want the same thing. We both dream of the same thing. One more circle through my old range. And if I die out on these high lonesome plains, leave my bones bleaching, let them shine in the sun. And if I'm lucky, some coyote's gonna take them further on a little. Further on. Land of shining mountains, big Alberta sky,
sentinels of the prairie, my own heart's delight.
Well, I'll look for you, my old friend. If I'm ever back this way again, on one more circle through my old range. If I die out on these high lonesome plains, we'll leave my bones bleaching, let them shine in the sun. And if I'm lucky, some coyote's gonna take them further on, a little further on, like maybe to Longview, or down to Elko. Roll on, Hawaii.
I'll see you again someday soon.
Ian, let's go get us a drink at Stockton's.
Wasn't that something beautiful? Piano by Stuart McDougall and the production wizardry of Ben Crane. Man, can't wait to see Ian and Ryan in Kamloops. Well, Don Howard is still on the line from the home ranch in the Hand Hills. Right now, the snow is about 3 feet deep, but the good news is the mosquitoes haven't been too bad. But according to you, Don, in your new book, you can really have a lot of them out there sometimes.
Only sometimes. Like, if we get a real rainy spell and it's muggy, mosquitoes get pretty bad. But, yeah, they weren't bad around our home place here that time. We hadn't had any rain. But out east, our pastures are about 20 miles east there, the summer pasture. And they could sure spoil a good ride or a game of golf, I guess, if there's enough of them. But we didn't have... Like I said, we didn't have many at the home place, but I went out there with my, I had a live-in quarters up front trailer, and I took a couple of horses out. And they were bad enough when I saddled up there. This was about evening time. And I rode out to the cows, and they were all in a tight bunch on top of a hill, and they were having a bad time. And, the mosquitoes were just howling around the cattle and howling around my horse there. There wasn't a place on his neck that it wasn't covered, or his head.
Oh,
he was getting a little panicky. And so I loped back to the truck as fast as I could there to get out of there, and turned the horse out into the corral. and figured they'd be okay out there fending for themselves, you know, the both of them there. I woke up about 5 o'clock, and I terrible noise outside there, noise and grunting and squealing. And I looked out, and I couldn't even see the horses for mosquitoes.
Oh, man.
Loud of them. And I opened the door, and there was just a howl. So I ran for a halter, and I thought, well, I better get them out of there and get home. And I opened the trailer door, and then I went and opened the gate to the corral, and they bolted past me and ran over into the trailer all on their own. They knew it'd be safer in there, so I shut the trailer door and ran for the truck, and I said, I guess I'll check the cows another day.
Oh, man. Well, it's a great book, Don. Like I said, we had a few days where we were totally snowed in and we had no power, and snow was getting deeper and deeper and deeper, and when there was enough daylight coming through the windows, I just sat down with your book with the wood stove fire going beside me, and did I ever enjoy reading it. I mean, it's just, you know, we've all been through it. Everything you wrote about almost reminded me of something that happened to us somewhere in a similar situation.
Well, that's right. A lot of times somebody will come up and say, you know, I can relate to that story totally.
And if you'd like to buy a copy of Don's book, Wild Garlic and Dawn Scents, here's his number, 403-223-7918. Coming up, if you like Western swing, you'll enjoy this week's classic Song of the West. Then the great poet Terry Nash in the Cowboy Poetry Spotlight, when the Spirit of the West continues right after this. How about a weekend pass to the 24th annual Kamloops Cowboy Festival, March 19th to 22nd, 2020. Another outstanding lineup of the finest pure Western entertainers anywhere. Canadian legend Gary Velger.
Searching for freedom, westward the wagons, they settled in the valleys of sagebrush and pine.
Tom Cole.
In a big prairie moon. Rides the big prairie sky.
The first Kamloops appearance for Doug Figgs.
A good horse under me, it's easy to see. I'm right here where I want to be.
A pasture full of great cowboy poets, the BC Cowboy Hall of Fame inductions, dinner shows, daytime entertainment, and a spectacular art and gear show workshop. The best place to get all the information, bcchs.com. To order tickets, call 1-888-763-2221. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West. This week's classic Song of the West was written by Johnny Mercer for the film Rhythm on the Range, and it was sung by the star of the movie, Bing Crosby. And the commercial version by Bing Crosby was made on July 17th, 1936, and it was a big hit. In fact, members of the Western Writers of America chose it as one of the top 100 Western songs of all time. And this version, From Asleep at the Wheel, features the voices of Ray Benson and Michael Martin Murphy, and I'm pretty sure you'll know the title.
I'm an old cowhand from the Rio Grande, but my legs ain't bowed and my cheeks ain't tan. I'm a cowboy who never saw a cow, never roped a steer, cause I don't know how. I sure ain't fixing to start in now.
Yippee-i-o-ki-yay.
Oh yeah.
Yippee-i-o-ki-yay.
I'm an old cowhand, I come down from the Rio Grande, and I learned to ride, 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 for I learned to stand. I'm a riding fool who is up to date. I know every trail in the Lone Star State, cause I ride this range in a Ford V8.
Yippee-i-o-ki-yay.
Yippee-i-o-ki-yay.
town just to hear the band. We know all the songs that the cowboys know about the big corral where the doggies all go, 'cause we learn them all on the radio. Yippee-i-yo, ki-yay. Oh yeah, yippee-i-yo, ki-yay.
And I'm an old cowhand down from the Rio Grande, where the West is wild all around the borderland, where the buffalo roam around the zoo, the Indians run up a rug or two, the old Bar X is just a barbecue.
Yippee-i-yo-ki-yay, yippee-i-yo-ki-yay.
I'm a pioneer who began from scratch. I don't bat an eye in a suit or a hat.
Sure.
They don't call me Elmer, they call me Satch.
Yippee-i-yo-ki-yay. Yippee-i-yo-ki-yay. Yippee-i-yo-ki-yay.
Hugh McLennan and the Great Western Spirit Band, along with Tom Cole and friends, will be at the Lido Theater in Fort St. John, B.C. for two shows, May 22nd and 23rd at 7 p.m. The crisp, clean music of the West, great guitar picking, spellbinding stories, and lots of laughs.
Where the sky goes on forever,
forever,
where those prairie winds blows a cold and hard.
Tickets available online at thelido.ca or call 1-250-785-3011. Or you can go to the Lido in person on 100th Avenue in Fort St. John.
Dream riding, dreaming my troubles away.
Now that is going to be so much fun. Hope to see you there. And now, a guy I know you'll enjoy at the Kamloops Cowboy Festival from March 19th to 22nd in the Cowboy Poetry Spotlight. Here's Terry Nash.
I'm unsettled these days, just slightly off track. It's almost been a year since I was horseback. I daydream now and then and think about past years when I viewed summer range between two pointed ears. I long for the small things that come with the life, like saddling a mount at morning's first light, and the sound of the knickers when the trailer'd pull in, the handshakes and howdies of old pards brought a grin. Then riding with good friends, looking for cattle, checking them all meant a full day astraddle. I pined for that thick smell from a working day's sweat, when I'd strip my cack and the blanket was wet, and the soft, quiet sound of a horse chewing hay while I leaned on the rail at the end of the day. In mountains or desert, just follerin' cows, my mind would rest easy if I was back here right now.
Well, thanks so much for riding along this week, and I sure hope you can be here next week at the same time. And as always, thanks to the Spirit of the West support crew, Mark and Kathy McMillan. And if you're looking for tractor parts, Mark is the guy that can help. See his page, bctractorparts.com. And if you enjoy this program, I know you'll enjoy Canadian Cowboy Country Magazine. You can subscribe online at cowboycountrymagazine.com. Hope you can check out the YouTube version of this program, and if you enjoy it there, if you like and subscribe, that'll really help us. A lot of our past shows are there as well, and get the links on our website, hugh-mclennan.com. Till next week, I'm Hugh McLennan. Hope to see you down the trail somewhere real soon.